You have any true crime fans in here at all? Hell yeah. Love us some true crime. The thing with that is, like, once you really get into it, you can't go back to fake crime. Which I think says a lot about humanity. You're like, oh, wasn't a real family that was butchered? Don't care. Don't give a shit. That's not... And I didn't realize how disconnected my own humanity was until one night when my wife and I were watching a late-night documentary on a serial killer. He killed a lot of people up to the point I'm talking about, and she and I are watching it and having a snack. Have not lost our appetite at any point during this murder spree. And then... commercial comes on. What's the commercial? Oh, ASPCA ad. Oh, sad, abused animals, right? Hungry cats, dogs with three paws, right? Hamster with a black eye, you know? Sad song comes on. It's like, oh, this is, can't we just go back to the dead hookers? This is really, but can't we just go back to all the fun we were having with them finding torsos in a ditch? This is some sad, you know, they got a bunny on crutches. Like, come on, man. I'm a human being. Go back to the death that we were enjoying before this. Our favorite show to watch is Dateline. I don't know if we have any Dateline fans in here. Specifically the Keith Morrison episodes. Because Keith, God bless him. Well, first of all, if you haven't seen Dateline, it's all about people killing people. That's all you need for a good murder mystery, right? But Keith, God bless him, at least three times a show for absolutely no reason. We'll just throw some puns in there. You know, because that's what's truly lacking in this horrific tale of greed, vengeance, and murder is a few yucks. Because Keith will be like, what started out as anti-freeze wound up becoming anti-life. Like, Jesus, Keith, come on, that's not... She was a mom, for Christ's sake. They're orphans now. The one thing the competitive eating champion never thought he'd bite was the dust. God damn it, Keith. What are you... That's not cool. Sticks and stones would have broken his bones, but it was the bullet that killed him. Motherfucker. What are you, razzing the guy? It's not a roast, Keith. He's dead. He was 85.